Let's have a look at another building, completely different style of thing. We're in a quite a fortunate position that, for instance, some people who prefabricate homes in timber, they think, well, my factory could also be built in timber. So there are a lot of people who are very innovative and they want to have some special solutions. So in this case here, I'm showing you a fabrication plant to prefabricate homes with a big open space on the bottom to be able to work according to the rules. On top of that, office for the crew working in this company, and on top of the office, dwellings or apartments which they rent out to other people. So if you think again about building physics, if you rent the place up on top, you don't want to have the vibrations coming through or the noise coming through. So there have been a lot of thinking about how to find the best solution to do that. This building is sitting right in the middle of a residential area, so there have been many thoughts about where to place entries and exits to not disturb the people. They wanted to have state-of-the-art solutions. In Switzerland, we are currently building mostly in spruce. This is our favorite or the most common building material, but with the climate change, the spruce is starting to suffer actually from this climate change. It's too warm and too dry. So there are actually tendencies showing that in the future we are going to use more hardwoods. So the softwood will be replaced naturally by hardwoods. Hardwoods in Switzerland is really underexploited. Beech, for instance, heaps of beech, around 40% of our forest is beech. So there are now tendencies trying to use that beech. And this guy said, okay, this is a tendency. Why don't we have columns, for instance, in beech and to do some additional studies on that? So very interesting kind of partner to work with. And what we have, so this is the factory from the outside. So big open space here, office, and then the apartments on the top. So during that process, we have had several little projects, again, at our school, where our future engineers could do some investigations, calculations, maybe testing. So they developed a column that is as strong as a concrete column, all prefabricated in hardwood. In this case here, even composite action with some glued-in reinforcing bars. So there were some side projects done, some reports done by our students, in order to actually build this this factory here. Let's have a look at this column. It's a massive column. The span is quite big. It's about 30 meters spans. And if you think that on top you have offices and on top you have apartments, you might have internal columns just sitting somewhere in the middle of nowhere, and the forces you have to transmit somewhere to the column. So these columns take quite a lot of force. You can see here the solution they developed. This is one third of the column with the grooves that take these rebars, which are glued in the end. There were some additional drillings, which you can also see here. These fellows here are for connecting the forces at the bottom, and these are the connections with the rebars in the system. So it's a three-part block glued solution. So there are many thoughts about it. People don't know exactly how to glue hardwoods. It's quite difficult, so some precautions have to be taken there. In the end, what you see is this timber column in hardwoods. You have the steel blade with mounted on the bottom. And in the end, in this case here, they would weld this bottom steel blade to the sitting steel connector, which is grouted into the concrete. So here you see, quite expensive developments, but people sometimes are interested in doing that. This was also one of the projects where first steps in BIM was kind of applied. You have all the data, all the position, all the geometry somewhere on the drawings. Why don't you just check all these conditions on site using the same data set? So that was what would happen here. As this column on top of that was welded onto this, it must be leveled 100% because this column must be really vertical in the right position. One other thing you also see, so this column is all prefabricated. You will see here just in a while the connection to the overhead crane. Beech is very sensitive to moisture movements, so forget it. To not covered during the erection process. As you can see here, this column is nicely covered until you come with the next elements to be sure that nothing happens in terms of shrinkage, swelling, and other nasties. Even the overhead crane was in timber, as you can see here. You can see here the devices that have been developed in order to make sure that no vibration from the overhead cranes goes into the upper stories. What you can see here, so this one side of the of that building was just a normal multi-story building with access and lift shafts and so on. It is very critical to make sure that there's no big setting of the structure. So solutions where you have horizontal timber sitting on a column and you bring through the load is not a good way to do it, because modulus of elasticity perpendicular to the grain is zero, 300, 20th of MOE. So what we try to do, or what people try to do, is to transfer the loads that come here, which are collected in this case here by a I-beam in steel, because in terms of size and load capacity, it's a very convenient kind of thing. You can slide in all your floor elements in there, you have an easy connection. You can connect this fellow here to an important steel part here, which kind of takes all these steel members and makes sure that all the compression runs through directly parallel to the grain contact. So this is one of the important issues if you're looking at multi-story buildings, especially to avoid bit settings and so on. This truss here is like the walk-in trusses in the bridges we have seen in the office space. This gives the space office height prefabricated fellow. Here again, you see no connection, so these are probably all done in having glued-in rods. The span is big. The forces from the upper stories give quite some substantial loads. So some of these diagonals might also be in hardwood, and just to react to the requirements you have from the load side. Then this actually is brought up and set on the column heads, which are very precisely oriented, because you cannot do any corrections when you bring up this this member here. This would then be the bottom part of a standard prefabrication plan, nicely organized with all the material flow studied accordingly. What you see here is the bottom cord of the truss that is sitting on top. And this would be the internal view of the office part. I think you can live with that. There's enough big space around to arrange your office, and you have a special feature which you also see at this reception point here. So this here, again, would be the top cord of these trusses you have seen before, prefabricated off-site, of course.